good to be back again to share the word with all of us. And before we go to the word, shall we have our opening prayer? Let's bow our head in prayer. Lord, we consecrate the rest of this time to you. As we open your Holy Bible to receive instruction and encouragement and wisdom from our great God as a church, Lord, may your word go forth, carried by the Holy Spirit, Lord, dividing the scriptures for our sake, O God. May we receive fresh revelation and manna as we feed on the Holy Word. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Praise God. I can't see. Oh, can I have the first slide, please? What I'm going to share today, the title is a bit unique, but I think by the end of the, I hope that by the end of the sermon, we will be able to understand and able to grasp what God is telling us. The message, the title of my message is, What If and Even If. What If and Even If. The whole text is taken from the book of Daniel in the Old Testament, chapter 3, verse 1 to 25. Daniel chapter 3, 1 to 25, it's a very long scripture, but as we go, we will go through it together. Can you? You know something about eyesight, no? You know, when you're young, you use size font 10. As you grow to 30 years old, you use 12. As you go to 40 years old, you use font 14. At my age, I'm using font 16. That's how high it is. What if, even if, 2021, we are one and a half months away to 2021, most of us would prefer not to relive another year like this. For the first time in our lives, we experience our world coming to a screeching halt, so to speak. Our schedules changing, jobs being taken away, large amount of time spent away from our loved one, or for some of us, saying goodbye to a loved one. What a tragic year. What a tragic time it was for me when I hear some of my friends succumbing to COVID-19 and other, all, especially COVID-19. Some of them were very young. We would not like to live another year like this again. There was a lot of, in Malaysia, racism, and there are a lot of political unrest. Perhaps some of us had a relatively normal year, but for the vast majority of us, 2021 was nothing but normal. It was a year we didn't expect, and when it came at us like a wrecking ball, most of us didn't know how to handle such a crisis. In my whole 60 plus years of life, I have never encountered a year like 2020 and 2021. I never knew the extent of one little virus that I can't see killing so many people and causing so much hardship. Perhaps some of us had the, with the new year approaching, we are 1.5 months away. I think by the next month, we will be starting our Christmas caroling and preparation for Christmas. But with the new year approaching, we can only hope for a different year. We hope that this coming year of 2022 will be better than 2021. How many of you are hoping for that? I'm praying for that. That things will come to a normal mode. We seem to survive with our heads barely above the water in 2021. How can we start off in 2022? 2021 and 2020 and 2021 seem to have more questions than answers that we can give. Many of those people who follow my sharing always ask me, Pastor, why like that? Why like that? Why like that? I say, I am not God. Nah. If I can tell you, I will tell you. We have many questions, but not many answers. It's easy to be hopeful and say that we want to start off strong. But what if our circumstances don't change in 2022? Even more, what if absolutely nothing about the world pandemic and chaos we are living in today doesn't change in 2022? What if 22 is the identical twin of 2021? Horrible. And perhaps the evil twin. In other words, how would you choose to live in 2022 if we are still living in the midst of chaos? Can I have the second? I want to explain myself. What do I mean by what if and even if? You see, the word what if, on Friday, I had a Zoom meeting with an NGO organization that deals with mental health. And there was this lady talking about anxiety disorders. And after her talk, there was the Q&A, question and answers. And many people asked her many questions. And I note that many of them asked their question by starting with, what if? What if the medicine doesn't work? What if he tried to commit suicide? What if, like so many people, I believe that, I don't have the actual statistics, but there are a lot of suicide cases because of the pandemic. What if? And this lady, psychiatrist, said, what if is the language of anxiety. Whenever you ask the word, what if, it shows your anxiety. But today, I would like to add one more adjective to that. What if is the language of fear. In the Christian context, what if? What if God doesn't bless me? What if? What if? What if? What if? That's the language of fear and anxiety. On the other hand, even if is the language of faith. Even if is the language of belief that God is able to do beyond what he said he would do for us. The language, what if, is the language of fear, is the language of anxiety. Even if is the language of faith, is the language of trust. That is what I mean. That is what I mean by the title, what if and even if. And I say, as I take you through the Bible, we will begin to learn to change our language from what if, the language of fear, to even if, the language of faith. Daniel 3 tells us the story of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Three young Israelite men who not only had faith in God, but showed their faith in their works. During this time, King Nebuchadnezzar set a golden image that was 90 feet high and 9 feet wide. That is Daniel chapter 3, verse 1. And commanded that everyone in town must bow to the statue and worship it whenever the music is played. Anyone who refused to worship the image would be thrown into a blazing fire. That was the decree Nebuchadnezzar gave to all the people who were taken into exile in Babylon. Reminds me of the time when I went to Thailand. How many of you been to Thailand? As you walk the streets of Thailand, Hat Yai, at 8 o'clock, they will play the national anthem and you have to stand. If not, they will catch you. This was what they did. 90 feet by 9 feet. When a certain, I don't know what music they play, but it certainly wasn't the music we sang this morning. The three men refused to worship the statue because they only worship God. How can we sing the Lord's song in a strange land? They were in a strange land, Babylon. And how could they bow down to the music at the 90-foot golden statue? The three men refused to worship the statue because they only worship God. So Nebuchadnezzar commanded that they may be thrown into the fire furnace and heated 7 times above the normal. I don't know how they tested the furnace in the olden days up to 7 times, but that's what happened. The three men responded in Daniel 3, verse 18. Now this is how they replied. They believed that God will rescue them and fix their situation. They said this, but even if he does not rescue us, we want you to know, your majesty, that we will not serve your gods or worship the image of God you have set up. Even if you throw us into the furnace, we will not worship your God. This coming 2020, are we going to make our stand? You know, there are many things that come in our way during the pandemic that can cause us to lose our direction and focus in God and do the things that God does not want us to do. God did rescue them that day, as he always did to his people. But can you imagine the trust, T-R-U-S-T, the trust these three men had in God? They could have moaned, "Ayo, why so difficult now? Why don't we just do what everybody is doing?" They could have complained and worried with all the what ifs. What the one if in the world? But they turned their one if into even if. Even if we will not concede, even if the just shall live by faith. They lived by faith. They have been justified, then they lived by faith. These are two very powerful words. It's knowing and believing, trusting God in every situation in 2022, even if it does not change the chaotic circumstances we are living in. It's saying to yourself, 2022 might be better, it might be the same, or it might be worse than 2021. I know God can find a family job, a job. But what if it doesn't? I know God can remove the coronavirus. But even if he doesn't, I know that God can heal my broken marriage and relationship. But even if he doesn't, the language of faith. Let's have faith that these three young men had, that no matter what we face in 2022, all the unknowns, all the what ifs, that we know about God is faithful and is that we know that our God is faithful and he is sovereign. I shared once in a church just these two words, three words. God is faithful. Remember, whatever situation, no matter how bad it is, may it be a financial situation, may it be any situation that you face in life, when it happens, just tell yourself, God is faithful. God is faithful. And what can the people of God say? Amen. God is faithful. No matter what circumstances, God is faithful. If God is not faithful, I won't be standing here sharing. You won't be sitting here listening to me. We are all here because God is faithful and because God is sovereign. What does it mean that God is sovereign? Such a big word. Why preach such a big word? God is sovereign means God has the final say. The pandemic doesn't have the final say. The politician does not have the final say. But God is sovereign. He has the final say. Though we know he can answer all our prayers, but even if he doesn't, we still will worship and trust him. That is what faith is all about. Despite situation that is adverse, we will be able to stand and say God is faithful and God is sovereign. Can we have the third one? No. The most beautiful things that come. Yeah. The most beautiful things can come from the most chaotic circumstances. I have gone through this many times and I have found to be true. You know, the most beautiful things can come through the most difficult times in our lives. And he make all things beautiful in my life. One of the most beautiful life-changing events to ever happen to us as believers happened during a culturally chaotic time. Did you know that Jesus was born in the midst of chaos? He wasn't born in a time when the land was fruitful, when the land was reigned by a friendly ruler. He was born in a time when there was chaos. And then an angel appeared to Virgin Mary, who was engaged to a man called Joseph. Talk about a scandal that would have made a good drama reality. Furthermore, Jesus Augustus was at the helm of the Roman Empire, proclaiming himself to be God. In the year Jesus was born, there was violence, there was chaos, there was political and social unrest. It was indeed a dark time in the history of the Israelite people. But at just the right time, when the world was dark, light was brought into our world. Jesus stepped into the chaos and brought peace. Fast forward this to ending 2021 and coming into 2022, we are experiencing similar things. I am hopeful and I am prayerful. But for those who feel the world is dark, Remember that even in the darkest time, light will shine and has stepped in. In chaos, in our chaos, He is there. In our darkest time, He is there. He brings light, and we can stay close to the light by staying close to Him through His Word. For His Word is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. Many of us, many people, those who are in the business, small-time business, those who are working in the tourism industry, many of them do not see a bright future. In the eyes of the world, 2020 would seem to be the same, although many places have been opened up. I heard that Friday, Saturday, and today, there are many people going to Penang because it's a long Deepavali holiday. They thought that it was free for all. But will it be next year? His Word shed enough light as a lamp to guide us one step at a time. And we must remain in His Word and allow His light to guide us through the dark times. Going through chaos doesn't feel good, nor at times does it look good. But remember, God Himself is good. We don't look at around circumstances for good. We look at the source of all things for good. We always say, God is good, and all the time, He is good. Do we believe that all the time He is good? Or do we shake, or do we tremble, or do we get into a panic mode when things are difficult? Beautiful things can be birthed in the darkest and the chaotic seasons. Trust that He has a purpose, and He wants to birth someone beautiful out of this chaos. As someone who has been teaching many people ask me many questions and I don't even have an answer. Really, I do not have an answer. And many times they say, what kind of a teacher are you? Ask you something or so you don't know. Go and talk to God lah. I say, I don't know. But one thing I know, God is faithful. One thing I know, He is in control. One thing I know, He is still in Malaysia. One thing I know, He is still with the church. He has not abandoned us. And that we must know. As we go through 2022, let us go with that kind of a confidence. He makes all things beautiful in His time. Before I became a Christian, I was a real, real rascal. But when I met Him, He made things beautiful in my life. You wouldn't want to meet me before I was a Christian. As we approach in 2022, in the midst of our current chaos, let's look at three ways we can remain strong as we head into the new year. Next one, please. We must, number one, live with a kingdom perspective. Live with a kingdom perspective. To start the year of 2022 off strong, we must change our perspective, the way we look at things, one that we lived in 2021. We must learn to adopt a kingdom perspective. Having a kingdom perspective is found in who you are believing in, not in what you are believing. Are you believing in a person or are you believing in things? Kingdom perspective. Looking at life in a kingdom perspective means we look at the world through the eyes of God. As we look through the world and we live in this world with the Holy Spirit leading us, living in the kingdom of God. Are you believing in the news, or are you our government, or a vaccine? Or recently, just 2 days ago, I read that I don't know which company, I believe it is Pfizer. They have found a pill. They have discovered a pill which can bring down the mortality rate of COVID-19 89%. How many of you want that? I don't want that because I don't want COVID also. Where is our perspective? Are we looking towards God? Are we looking towards God? Or are we just banking on technology, medical, bioscience, medical science? We should be having a kingdom perspective. Remember, God never changes. Even though the world around us does, He is the same today, He is the same yesterday, today, and tomorrow. Hebrews 13:8, four square gospel motto. Hebrews 13:8, kingdom perspective. Number two, fix your focus. Most of us at some point most likely focus on all the wrong things in 2021. We have spent too much time focusing on the news of the pandemic, the riots, the political headlines, you will have a field time if you are living in Malaysia and following Malaysian politics. It's a real cartoon where the loser becomes the government. The government is kicked out when they go to the whatever it is. I think you know what's happening. To start off 2022, we must fix and adjust our focus. Colossians chapter 3, verse 2 says, set your minds on things that are above, not on earthly things. Think about it. Let the word of God speak to you. Where is your mind set on? Previously, there was a song, I got my mind set on you. I got my mind set on you. Where is your mind set on? Is it set on the economy? Is it set on the culture? Is it set on the political situation? Let it be set on the things above and not the earthly things. Earthly things will come and they will go. But the things of God above will ever remain and will always be there for us. Make a list of the things you focus as your top things in 2021. Were they focused on things above or the things of this world? Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look full in His wonderful one, huh? And the things of this world will grow strangely dim in the light of His glory and grace. I have heard all the news. One thing I have decided to do very recently, I have canceled myself from the TV, Malaysian TV. I have canceled myself away from the Malaysian TV. Because Malaysian TV station 1 to 7, 8 are all government control. And you have nothing else but all the negative things, things which are unjust. How many of you recently received through your WhatsApp a packet of rice with $50? None. Anybody? Oh, sorry, huh? I thought you had. And instead of watching the news and seeing how we, the recent budget, the Chinese and the Indians, that's all of us, receive only 3% of the budget allocated. The rest it was for the Keluarga Malaysia. I asked my friend, how many of you know Stephen Sim? He was complaining, oh, 3% only. I said, that's why you got fooled. The Prime Minister said, untuk Keluarga Malaysia. Keluarga Malaysia means them, bukan Cina dan Hindu. Cina Hindu 3% saja. Bill 3. Next one, please. Be your life planted in the Lord. Blessed is the man, Jeremiah 17, 7 to 8. Blessed is the man who trusts in the Lord and whose hope is in the Lord. For he shall be like a tree planted in the waters which spread its roots by the river and will not fear when the heat comes. But the leaf will be green and will not be anxious in the year of drought, nor will cease from yielding fruit. Plant it deep. Blessed is the man who trusts in the Lord. David, in his 23rd Psalm, wrote that the Lord is shepherd, he shall not want. Everything, you know, he listed me in the green pastures. Surely goodness, mercy shall follow him. All of those things. Was that true? Did it come true? How many of you said it came true? I found out and it came true. Did he say it came true? Yes. If you turn your Bible to Psalm 37, verse 25. Psalm 37, verse 25 says this. I was young. I think I also can say the same thing. I was young and now am old. But I have never seen the righteous of the Lord being forsaken or their children begging for food. 37, verse 25. I was young and now old. When David wrote Psalm 23, he was a young shepherd boy. But when he was writing Psalm 37, 25, he says, with golden hair, he might be leaning on his staff, and he wrote Psalm, he says, I was young and now I am old, but never have I seen the righteous forsaken, nor the children begging for food. Grab hold of that. Grab hold of that. There are gems in the Psalms. You know, there are many things that we can learn from the book of Psalms. Cut short and all that. When the lockdown hit in 2020 towards the end, I lost all my preaching engagement. All. I can't even come here. I couldn't go to Sungai Petani, Kulim. My favorite country in Sarawak, I couldn't go. I lost everything. I told him myself, Jalat ni alon. I'm gone. Then God says, no. You may be gone, but I am here. If I am here, you are not gone. I am sure many itinerant preachers lost many things. They couldn't get out of the country. Then one day, I met a friend. He was telling me, Richard, you cannot go anywhere to share already, huh? Susah for you, huh? I said, yeah, nah, very susah for me. He said, why don't you share to others? I said, how? He said, through Facebook, lah. Facebook can, lah. Can. And I use my little broadcasting station, lah. This little broadcasting station. And I turn to Facebook, and he said, you press live. I press live. Lo and behold, everybody could see now. And from that day onwards, I have been sharing every Sunday. Every Sunday for 2 years. 9 o'clock until even last Sunday, ask Marie. Even last Sunday. And this Sunday, tonight also, there's another live streaming. I could share. God gave me another platform. You lost this? God gave me another platform. And now, instead of only to a few people in the church, it went very far. At the first sharing, I have friends from Czechoslovakia, Sarawak, New Zealand, Australia. And I tell Lord, wow, this is a real wonderful platform. You are truly a wonderful good God. Just by clicking on platform, I can speak to so many people at one time. And you know what? Along with this opportunity came the blessing, came financial blessing. People who supported me. I'm not talking about the money that people supported me. I'm talking about the opportunity that God is able to turn an adverse situation and make it into something new, which we don't even expect. Walking with God doesn't make us exempt from chaos, but we have a source where we can bear fruit during any season. We have no idea what 2022 will be like, but one thing we know is that when we put our hope and trust in God, being anxious for nothing, still bear fruit and receive His blessing. To start 2022 strong, let's plant ourselves in the Lord, abiding in the Word, so that if there's a fire, drought, or even chaos continue, we will not fear, nor will we cease from yielding God bearing fruit. This verse from Jeremiah speaks about the man, the tree, that is planted beside the river, whose roots are deep, that goes deep into the ground. And you know, in places like Israel, there are times when it is very hot, when there's no rain for a long time. The tree will still flourish. The tree will not die. It will still bear fruit. Why? Because the roots are deep and they are connected to the river. Are you built by the river, deep into the river? You are in rivers of water, I know. But are you deep in the rivers of water in the Lord? Let's put 2021 behind us and look ahead. As Philippians 3:13 says, to forget what is behind and pressing on forward to those things which are ahead. So let us start 2022 strong. by adopting a kingdom perspective, by fixing our focus on the Lord, the one in whom we can trust, as we build our family, as we build our life firmly with Him, we can start 2022. Thank you, Lord, that although the world is around us is full of unknown, yet you are the unshakable known God. The things of us around us are so unknown. Things can change just like that. People die just like that. Circumstances just die like that. Business just closed down just like that. But God never closes down. God doesn't have a time of lockdown. It's only we who lock down ourselves. Praise be to God. That's my message that I'm sharing today. Shall we stand? Close this time in prayer. Lord, much has been said this morning, Lord. May we absorb your truth just like the ground that absorbs the fresh water, O Lord. May each one of us be never be the same again as we walk through the days ahead. May we shout, praise the Lord for all that has been spoken. And may, Lord, may we dismiss, Lord, with your blessings, O God. Father, may we take home something that is precious from your word, O God. Lord, I do not know how your Spirit has spoken to your people this morning. But I know, Lord, that you are the immutable God, that you are the God that never changes, O God. Then we can trust in you, O God. We thank you for this morning, O God. Father, now we want to pray a blessing upon God's people, O Lord. Now unto him who is able to keep you from stumbling and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory and exceeding joy, to God our Savior, who alone is wise, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever. And all God's people say, Amen. Thank you.